do a hard dump.
You're probably wondering what I was just doing. Well, I was decanting wine. And today we're going to talk about why, when, and how to decant wine. But as always, there's a little red subscribe button down there. Let's go ahead and punch it. Click it. Decanting. What does it actually mean? Well, decanting means you take liquid from one vessel and gradually pour it into another vessel without disturbing any sediment in the initial vessel. If that's confusing, it's dictionary.com's fault and not mine. In antiquity, the reason to decant wine, because of the lack of modern technology, what we would do is we would put wine in a vessel and let it sit for quite some time and allow all the organic material to fall to the bottom of the vessel, then transfer that liquid into another vessel while not disturbing the sediment, hence the definition of decanting. Fast forward out of antiquity, when glass was around, the British used something called rock crystal to decant their wine. I'll show you what it looks like. You may recognize this from, I don't know, your grandfather's wet bar, Mad Men. This is where whiskey is stored these days. Now, back in the day, this was a decanter. There's a top on it because no bugs got in it and it kept the wine as fresh as possible while all the sediment fell to the bottom of the decanter. And when it did, they'd transfer the wine into cups or glass. So that's how people decanted wine. That's how you decant. But that's not how we do it in the modern times. It's not how we do it now, because these days we have modern technology. We don't need to deal with throw off unless the bottle is old. In that case, we do. Now, fast forward to 1980-ish. Chateau Latour, one of the most famous chateaus in all of Bordeaux, makes wine that ages for years and years and years. They decided they wanted to create a vessel that helped aerate these wines from Bordeaux because they're so austere in their youth. And even if they've aged, they need time to breathe a little bit. And if they've aged, they have throw off. So what Latour did is they designed a glass vessel with a wide base that would hold an entire bottle of wine. And the base was wide enough that it left a wide surface area that helped encourage oxygen to attack the wine and open it up. And this is what it looks like. Now, this isn't the original one, but what they did was set the standard, I believe, for what we use today. But really, if we think about the definition of decanting, this is actually the decanter. Because the way it works now is when a wine is old, you let it sit for, I don't know, a day sometimes, depending on how old the wine is. You let all the sediment fall to the bottom, and then you decant the wine into the decanter. See what I'm doing here? Before we decant anything, we gotta clean this. It's a little bit dirty, but how do we do that? Keith, you take some salt, make it coarse, and you take some ice and crush it up. Take a little bit of salt, not a lot, not even a tablespoon, just like a little smattering of salt, coarse salt into the decanter. You take crushed ice, dump it in there, and just vigorously get it in, just like move forward like that, and just shake it up like that. And then you can even like turn it upside down and go up and down like that and get it straight like that. And all you're trying to do is get that salt to scrape around the side while being softened by the water that's being melted by the ice, and everything kind of rushes around and takes all the stains off. Then what you do is you dump all that out. You get a pitcher of water, you just go to this faucet, you just keep on rinsing, dumping until you don't see any stains, you wipe it down, and you got yourself a clean decanter and you haven't spent a lot of money. Although the decanter beads are kind of cool. The shape of this bottle is called a Bordeaux bottle. If you see a Pinot Noir bottle, it's called a Burgundian bottle. The reason why this is shaped this way is because it has this shoulder here. And as wine ages and has throw off, if you were to have an older bottle of wine, you'd sit it up for a while, like I was talking about before, let it settle. And then what you would do is you take your thumb, put it right here so you don't hit the glass on glass. You hold it like this, you start pouring in. And as you pour, you monitor the shoulder. And if there was sediment in this bottle, which there's not, you would see very quickly sediment starting to float towards the shoulder. And as you get to the end, the sediment would collect at the shoulder of the wine, and you're done. You have a big surface area here. Oxygen's flowing in and attacking all that wine. That is how you decant old wine. If you are having a Tuesday night and you have one of these awesome looking things, all you have to do, and that will do it just well. And actually, if you're dumping, it's called a hard pour or hard dump. But if you do that, you're actually aerating the wine. Never buy a gadget that proposes to aerate wine because it doesn't do what you think it does. And that's red wine. We always talk about decanting wine, we talk about red wine. The thing is, guys, decant whatever you want. Wine always benefits from air. It's called aeration. Oxygen needs to get into that wine, start opening up the wine, start breathing a little bit, whether it's $25 or $80. Any wine can benefit from some air. I'm about to say something crazy. You can decant red wine. You can decant white wine. You can decant rosé. You can even decant sparkling wine. Whatever wine you want to open up will work. And what's really cool about that is decanters look really sexy on the table. So watch this. All we want to do is get air in here. Do a hard dump. Just decanter the wine. You don't need a decanter. It's great to have a decanter, but this is basically aerating wine. So that's decanting, whether it's in a decanter, or it's in a pitcher, or just trying to get air in a wine. And I showed you that pitcher because there's something I do not want you to do, and I blame the writers of Succession. I understand you had a job to do, it's very dramatic, but please don't commit murder. I'll show you what I'm talking about. This wine lovers is not a decanter. The idea of hyperdecantation is a bit of a myth. A winemaker spent a lot of time growing vines, harvesting grapes, making wine, blending wine, and building something for us to enjoy. And the reason we aerate and decant wine is to encourage that wine to open up. Because what we're doing is we want to encourage it to get to a place that the winemaker thought about when they were making the wine. If you pour wine into a blender and hyper decant it, you're literally committing slaughter. You are slaughtering the wine. Don't slaughter wine. Look, it's your wine. You do whatever you want. Once you buy a bottle, it's yours. I'm just saying, this will strip the phenolics and do things to the wine that will change it in a way that it won't be as it was intended. Just putting it out there. So I wanna know, have you ever decanted wine? Do you have a decanter? Do you like decanting into pitchers? Have you decanted white wine, rosé, or sparkling wine? And how'd it go? Did you decant in a blender? Let me know in the comments below and then we can fight about blenders. I'm Keith Beavers, and don't decant, decant. Am I right? Talk to you next week. I'm using decant, do not talk about it.